Hello and welcome, my Aries Collective Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. Welcome to your Twin Flame read for August and September 2020. I am your reader, Marcangela Lyons Mal, for short, professional witch, professional intuitive, president of Join the Circle Productions, and very, very happy to be serving you today in your contract read for your Twin Flames. My subscribers, thank you so much for following along and helping me out. I think you guys are going to like what we're doing this time around. You know, the gods, my pantheons, all of them, they're always changing up the reading, so I stay interested so that you will stay interested. This time we're doing an extended. Oh, you'll see. You're going to get enough bang for your buck right here, right now, I have a feeling. We're looking at an 18-card spread, looking at the contract between you and your most dominant, prominent twin flame relationship for August and September 2020. You can always expect some overlap from month to month. I think you'll dig it. I just did one for my own twin flame contracts to have a look-see-dook-see at it, and it seemed pretty right on the nose, made me cry a little bit. We're using the two new oracles, the Kuan Yin Oracle and the Blue Angel Oracle, so we're in for quite a wild ride, I have a feeling. But if you are new to my channel, please do consider liking, subscribing, and all of that jazz. Comment as you see fit. Let's get up in this gig, and remember, there will be an extended on Vimeo.com. So, if you are unfamiliar with what a twin flame is, because there's all sorts of different definitions, there are links in the description box below, but essentially to say that it's a form of soul contract, like soulmate, but different. But where you teach each other how to love yourselves, you teach each other how to heal yourselves, which just seemed lovely on paper until you realize, because they can't give you the love, the respect, the boundaries that you want from them, and vice versa. So you learn to give it to yourself. They are absolutely essential. They are not all romantic, sexual. They can certainly be parental. Nor do you only have one. You can have all sorts of different twin flame contracts in all different areas of your life, and I like that definition much better than the one that's been floating around for, decades, a century? I don't know how long that one's been going around, but there are just links in the description box that at least define how I look at it. Cool, cool? Which I think is way more helpful, because you need lots of soulmates to balance out your twin flames, and there you have it. Contract law, raised by a lawyer, what do you want? So all I need you to do is remember that it is a general read. We are doing masculine, feminine. You're going to have to feel which one you are, which one resonates, because we're different ends of the polarity with different people in our lives. But I think you'll get the gist as we go along. And let's dive in and do this. Please focus on your breath. I will do the same. And we'll see where it gets us. Here we go. Oh, all the decks that I read are in the description box below. I added the two new ones. So we are ready to rock and roll. Check, 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 check. Let's do this. Breathe. I'm going to start with two cards from the Caroline Mace archetype deck. The voices of the collective pantheons, that all the pantheons connected to this reading on the table at the moment and in the ethers, please. I need two cards, one for the divine feminine and one for the divine masculine, in this Aries collective Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs for August and September 2020, please. Who is the divine feminine? What is their dominant archetype soul power being developed in this twin flame contract? And who is the divine masculine, the counterpart in this twin flame contract? August, September 2020. Now, keep in mind, these can be triggery. It's got light and shadow. The shadow is what this contract is helping you, teaching you. How to heal on your own, how to love within yourself, the light attribute, the gold, showing you where you're headed in the evolutionary trajectory of the archetypal pattern and soul power. We've got the divine feminine goddess and the divine masculine beggar. Oh, snap. Did he snap, snap, snap? The shadow attribute of the goddess archetype, exploitation of the female nature and form, and certainly that could be in a male or a female body, right? The archetype is very genderless in that sense. Definitely one of the divine feminine family archetypes, but there you have it. The light attribute, the feminine expressed through wisdom, nature, life force, and sensuality. So rather vague, but there are certain people who have just a want to say a deific energy about them, meaning of like a deity, but that definitely have that god or goddess power that they carry with them. So whoever the divine feminine is here, she's a handful. And remember, can be a guy too. It's never about biological gender, divine masculine, divine feminine. We all have those within us. And that's why the divine masculine here, the beggar, is very interesting. The shadow attribute, dependence on others to the exclusion of effort, and that's my rub with it. It's like, I'll help people to the best that I can, but you gotta do your part of it. But the light attribute is actually rather holy. Confronts empowerment at the level of physical survival. Awakens the spiritual authority of humility, compassion, and self-esteem. So remember, not everybody who begs for money. They beg for attention. But are they doing the work? Inner and or outer. Very, very interesting. Again, twin flames right out the bat, right out the door, right off the bat. Troublesome, traumatic, transformative. That's what the twin flames are, man. The twin flames, they're the crucible. It's the alchemy of it all, teaching you to love the aspects of yourself that may rise only when you're around this person, what they trigger in you. Right? Let's keep going. Remember, this need not be sexual or romantic, but I could see where it could be too. What are the angels that you could call upon working with you both individually? My angels, please, one card each for this goddess archetype and this beggar archetype. Don't know who's who. Could be either of you in this Aries collective sun, moon, rising, Venus sign. Who is the angel that walks with the goddess archetype here, that goddess power in the divine feminine? Who's the angel walks with them? Meditation. Good, good. Who walks with the beggar, please, my angels? Who we got there? Trust. Now, what would the healing angels, this is healing with the angels oracle, what would the angel of meditation, because remember, it's not a name, it's a title, the angel of meditation, what would be helping the divine feminine heal within herself? Well, certainly more the internal world, the world of the soul, the feminine energy, right? Though expressed through wisdom, nature, life force, and sensuality, to give a time of contemplation, perhaps even a resting, a letting the field rest, right? All that earth element in there, though we're talking about Aries here. This could be the Aries just as much. But that goddess energy, particularly if there has been exploitation somewhere in there, to meditate upon that, to rest. I mean, we all got to do what we got to do. For this beggar archetype, however, is trust, which I really think is a very, very powerful thing. I mean, there have always been beggars on the planet. I mean, I'm not even necessarily talking socioeconomic stuff here. I'm talking scriptural. Like, how far back? Like, even into Greek myth, there's just, I've always been those. And so it's an ancient, ancient archetype, the beggar. But with the angel of trust, right? If the angel of meditation is going to bring in healing for this divine feminine, right, through meditation, then there's something here about trust, about the humility, right? The spiritual humility of authority of humility, compassion, and self-esteem. That there's a trust issue going on here in this relationship, and for them to work on that within themselves, that is something that only they can do for themselves in terms of, right, dependence on others to the exclusion of effort. That takes some effort to at least find that trust in something higher, which is, you know, an ongoing journey as well. All right, so we've got our two characters here, our twins. Now we're going to build tarot around each of them. We're going to do an element spread for each, daughters of the moon for the divine feminine goddess, and we've got the mythic tarot for that beggar archetype. Let's have a looksy-duxy. Breathe. This has already got a hook to it. I can feel it in my solar plexus. Please. My goddesses, one card in clarity for this goddess in this Aries collective sun, moon, rising, Venus signs. Please, element of fire, what is it that she wants and desires, truly, truly wants and desires from this twin flame contract? Come on, August, September 2020. What does she have the element of Earth to help her get that? Just leave it in my hand. Thank you. Doing them face down, I'll do the same for him, the Divine Masculine. And then we'll turn them over element by element. My goddesses, what is she thinking? Her element of air, she, the divine feminine, thinking in terms of the element of air. What is she, the divine feminine, I know, feeling? Is the divine feminine feeling element of earth in this? Two, just one, please just leave it in my hands. Please just leave it in my hands. We'll take that one. That's good. And finally, the element of spirit. What is the point of view, the voice of the soul that agreed to this contract in the first place? Their perhaps higher vision point of view, something that might be missing from the equation for the personality. Okie dokie, let's do the same for him real quick. And we will get down on it. Come on in, get down on it, breathe. Switching channels, but not drastically, to the gods, the divine masculine. My gods, please. Five cards, element spread for this divine masculine beggar in this Aries collective sun, moon, rising, Venus sign, twin flame contract. August, September 2020. What's his element of fire, please? What does he want? There's his element of fire. What is his element of earth to help him get what he wants and desires in this contract? What is his element of air? What's he thinking about all of this? Okay. What's he feeling, this beggar archetype, about and in and around and through this contract? And what is the card of spirit, the point of view of the soul that signed the contract and embodied into this soul contract, August, September 2020? Okay, don't know what any of them are. Just gonna move these over a touch so I have a little bit more room. I am a Virgo, you know, not totally symmetrical, but working on it. Let's have a look-see. Dooksy, just doing that and that. Element of fire, what do you both want? Well, Divine Feminine wants the Ten of Cups, that fulfillment, that ecstasy, and that bliss. And the Divine Masculine wants the Eight of Wands, that passionate communication. There we go. I think we know what we're dealing with here right now. This already feels a little sexual, romantic. Good for you. Aries, they don't always work that way. Good for you. The romantic, sexual twin flames are some of the hardest, right? Because it's not like it's family where there's a DNA link where you can walk away, right? It's like where you can't walk away from those. These ones, they're really hard to walk away from. But that totally does make sense, that what you want here is probably more of each other. Now, keep in mind, twin flame contracts, they're turbulent. You're learning how to give yourself the love that they can't, but I get the attraction. I get the attraction big time. What's the element of earth? What do you have to help you get what you want? Well, it feels like the Divine Masculine is taking the reins of the Chariot. Now, keep in mind, they are dealing with the beggar archetype. So how does the beggar archetype take control, right? It's got to be in the light there, confronting empowerment at the level of physical survival. So their challenges are pretty clear here in terms of what they have to kind of overcome to communicate with you. I can just see that Eight of Wands, that wanting to sort of rush in with more than just a communication, but very fast moving stuff. While you've got the Three of Flames, which is often, you know, in Three of Wands considered waiting, but I don't get just waiting here. What I get is, yeah, you know what you want and you are willing to wait for it, but that's more in terms of loyalty to yourself. Like, I'm not getting, well, you're an Aries, right? Maybe you're not the Aries, right? You could be the twin in this one. Crosswatcher, I guess that would make you. But I can feel the stability here, that you've got the goddess here, right, moving into that light attribute with that card of meditation, that you know what your inner priorities are, your loyalties to yourself, to the divine, to your friends, to your family, your self-worth, and being loyal to oneself and one's honor code in particular. Because there does feel something a little tricky-sticky here, which is what twin flame conflicts are. Even within families, twin flame contracts, they're tricky-sticky. What's the element of air here? Well, you're both dealing major arcana cards in the mental. The divine feminine goddess archetype here has the card of Shakti, the life dancer, the completion of a cycle, the card of the world or the universe, last card before the major arcana reboots at the Fool. And around we go. That it feels like that's coming from the meditation, that from that angel of meditation, sort of getting the visions of seeing a completion and seeing light at the end of the tunnel here. Whether or not you get what you want, it feels like if you're loyal to yourself, you will get that Ten of Cups with or without this person, but let's keep going, because the way they see it is they've got a decision to make, probably about love, probably about the goddess here, right? So let's be clear. This isn't the person I'm reading for. This isn't the person I'm reading for. I'm reading for both of you. Whoever you are, whoever the Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign is here, what you have in common is almost, you could say, an Aries quality of really seeing things similarly. Like, one is seeing the end, not maybe the end of this, the conclusion of a chapter, maybe the start of another one, not necessarily a death and rebirth, and this one as a major decision. Trying to balance head and heart here too, and I do get with this trust angel on top of this that there are some physical issues going on here, and by physical it can mean economical, the economy, money, finances, stuff like that they're giving me, as well as just environment, depending on the situation, like the environment of where they are, the people they are with, making a little tricky crazy. That might be why they want to sort of get out of Dodge so quick and move on into this contract, whoever that is. So what are you feeling? What are you feeling? What are you feeling? Well, the goddess, the divine feminine here, is feeling the emotional connection, bonding, maybe at a friend level right now, but feeling definitely wanting to go more, that there is a friendly thing here. Now, if this is a case of unrequited love, as does happen, where one person's seeing it one way, yeah, but with the lover's card in the mind, I think that the divine masculine is aware that there's a... You know, that there's a loving, wise, powerful decision to be made here that probably does involve the emotions of this divine feminine, just with the predominance of water. We'll still have one more card to look at. But this is also saying for the divine feminine goddess, keep an eye on your empathic skill of intuition, right? You might be feeling things that are not your own. That could be very... confusing. That's a nice way to say it, right? When you think it's what you're feeling, but it's what they're feeling, and it doesn't matter time or space. It just doesn't matter. It's like a radio, or it's like a cell phone. It doesn't matter as long as your antenna is up. Let's not run with that metaphor. Because the divine masculine here has the hanged man, so sort of feeling like not knowing what to do, but a sacrifice is necessary of some kind. Perhaps the sacrifice of seeing this relationship from a more spiritual point of view, one from a place of divine trust. I mean, I've had to learn, well, and I say this all the time, not as a joke, but I mean it, in the Wiccan Read poetic version, Doreen Valiente, the first line, I believe, is, "Bide the Wiccan law, you must, in perfect love and perfect trust." Well, I'm not Wiccan anymore, but I still think perfect love and perfect trust of the gods alone, because everybody else has bad days, right? But if you are going to put your trust in anything, into a higher power, is really not a bad idea. Just understand that they're more interested in watching you grow and become the best that you can be. So a certain surrender to the divine, which is often, and this is Prometheus, talk about a liver problem, right? And it pecked out every day by, I think, a vulture, if I remember correctly. Definitely not a fun bird, not a hummingbird, a vulture, because he stole fire, right? Stole fire to give to humanity and got away with it, but didn't. So there is a certain thing there, that something can be gained here, but that something has to be sacrificed in its place for this to happen. Now, with one more card down, the spirit card, and I want to get there, I just want to point out that the divine masculine here has got a predominance of major arcana, right? The chariot, the lovers, and the hanged man. You put those three together, there's a lot of ability to move forward, but the decision hasn't been made mentally, so emotionally it's like, well... You know, hang out. Where she's seeing, the goddess here, is seeing the closing, or at least thinking about the closing of a chapter. So what is the point of view of the soul? point of the soul is saying for the divine feminine that this is the coyote woman, that there is a trick being played here. Now, the trick may not be as overt as the beggar tricking the goddess, so much as it might be, this is a twin flame that might feel like it's something else, right? Like, again, twin flames, they're tumultuous. They're often high drama, whether you see each other a lot or not, right? You don't have to be in, it's just tumultuous, traumatic, traumatizing, if that's not exactly the same, turbulent, but transformative, right? You're teaching each other how to love yourselves, how to heal yourselves. Don't forget that piece of it, because with that card of, for the goddess here, with meditation, to get that, you are being tricked into learning something about yourself, how to set a boundary, how to, all sorts of things, where your loyalty system lies. But I gotta say, with what you got here, it doesn't look that bad. Because the divine masculine, the beggar here, has the Six of Blades, which to me is such a card of therapy, right? Mental balance, moving from the turbulence of the Five of Blades into the Sixth of, you know, crossing over into, calmer emotional waters, but using the element of air, not the element of water, right? To see clearly, to navigate your way ahead, to bring yourself into balance. You know, there's so many different ways of doing that, but it's good. It's like the point of view of the soul is really saying, hey, but, you know, we're moving from more turbulent times into calmer water, and we are seeing things clearly, coming into a more mental balance, which would indicate here with the lovers as well, that to actually have the heart involved in this process as well, not just purely analytical, financial. I mean, like I said, this could be romantic, sexual, but I could see it playing out as a family member too. Like someone who's really got this divine feminine, more of that, you know, wisdom and wealth and that natural life force of the goddess, and one who's sort of like, finding their way through a rough time, a younger family member, perhaps a mother-child situation or parent-child. It's all sorts of ways it can play itself out, but that's why we ain't done yet. Because what we're going to do, we're going to get four more cards, and then, you know, we'll go into the extended after that. But one of them is this new oracle that I got, the Kuan Yin Oracle, sent to me as a birthday gift from Nancy Antonucci. Thank you, Nancy, so much, because I know you're going to watch the Aries reading. So thank you. I mean, I did my own this morning, this spread that I'm doing, and the card that was here, it brought tears to my eyes. It really, like, Kuan Yin got me right there. So let's ask her, and of course I will be reading excerpts from the book. There's a lot written about each card, so let's do this. Nice deep breath. As I breathe in the luminous pink smoke of Kuan Yin, that coral pink veil. Such a different frequency than the goddesses, is so specific. Kuan Yin, please. One card, if I may, in clarity for this Aries Collective Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign twin flame contract for this goddess archetype and this beggar archetype, please. What is your piece of clarity, your piece of divine feminine message for both of them, no matter who is watching this, this Aries Collective Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign twin flame contract, August and September 2020, please just leave the cards in my hand. Great Kuan Yin. And we've got drink from the Emerald Fountain. Will you just, Aries, just go drink from the Emerald Fountain. Card number 7. Not hard to look up, right? Except I just shot right past it. Drink from the Emerald Fountain. So first we get the description here. The divine feminine is encouraging of the awakening and empowerment of all living beings. Well, she would, wouldn't she? When a sincere seeker is trying to find the way through, there is much help sent. Now, I feel like that could apply very much for the beggar there. It makes sense to be open to receive it, indeed to step forward and drink from the Emerald Fountain, which is the unconditionally loving heart chakra of Kuan Yin. allow yourself to be nourished by the power and love of the Divine Mother flowing to you now. Now, I'm also going to say, I mean, we just have the Goddess card on the table here as well, so to keep that in mind for both of you to drink of. Now, there is just pages and pages here, so rather than go through all of that, I'm going to skip to the end to the prayer, because you know how big I am on prayer, so you're getting the at least this time around, you're getting the genuine, general interpretation of the card as well as the prayer. Divine Kuan Yin, beloved goddess that loves me unconditionally, you have my blessing and permission to assist me with divine energy that is for my highest good in all areas of my life now. I kneel at your sacred fountain of love, light, and divine assistance now. I drink from your heart that which fills my soul. I gratefully receive your unconditionally loving help. Omani Padme Hum. Praise be the jewel in the center of the lotus, or close to. Many different translations over the centuries. So drink from the emerald fountain. Now, that's the thing. Kuan Yin exists within all of us. That's sort of the point of unity consciousness. So to drink from the emerald fountain is about drinking of that divine love that we all have access to, but by all means, you can call upon her in this relationship. Now, if I am to be very honest, I can see both the divine feminine goddess archetype doing that, particularly with the amount of water cards we've got here emotionally. And as I look at the divine masculine beggar here, I'm not seeing any water cards at all. Granted, the lovers, and granted that six of swords in the soul position, talking about, you know, that emotional balancing, but using a mental thing. Perhaps a prayer like that would be helpful to restore some trust to drink from the emerald fountain. All right, moving along. See what I mean? It's like all of a sudden it takes such more of a mystical turn with these oracles. I'm digging it. And this one is from the same company, Blue Angel, except this is the Blue Angel Oracle. The company's name is Blue Angel. This is the Archangel Michael one, which I'm feeling is way more about the divine masculine, right? So we've got Kuan Yin for the divine feminine. Let's see what Archangel Michael says for the divine masculine in the relationship. This is both of you, the center lane, right? Breathe. Archangel Michael, breathing the blue smoke of Archangel Michael, please, my beloved, one card in clarity for this Aries collective sun, moon, rising, Venus signs. What do they need from your point of view, right? How are you seeing this, Archangel of truth, Archangel of protection and defense, and that beautiful third eye, throat chakra range of blue, the cobalt, the turquoise, please, one card in my hand for them, the eternal star, guidance. Ooh. Did you just get the eternal star number 24? Now, this is not as much written, but I think you'll dig it. The eternal star, guidance. Feel the star of light that you hold in your heart and follow your own inner guidance, no matter what others say. Boom. Right there. A twin flame thing. Like, no matter what each of you are saying or not saying to each other, no matter what each of you may hear from other people about each other or, you know, their opinions on your relationships in general, this is really about you following your guidance no matter what others say. What feels right in your heart is your truth, so let your heart be your guide. Do not agree to something that doesn't feel right. Others believe that they know what is best for you. Remember, you can always choose to disagree. You will still be loved no matter what you do. I am guided by life. I am guided by this breath. I am guided by the light that shines inside me. I am guided by all that I am. Rock and roll. I really love these. I really, really love these. And it's just so funny that the third deck I'm using to give you the center lane is the Whispers of Love, the first that I got from this company. I just didn't realize they were all from the same company. The Whispers of Love, the voices of the higher self, which in a way is the merger of the divine feminine and the divine masculine, because your higher self is both. It's both yet neither, whatever. The pregnant void of all that is. Ow. Paradox. Not right now. Ow. Breathe. So, I love this deck. Please, the higher selves of all involved. I could call you the higher self collective, but that's really the Holy Spirit. It's another thing. All the higher selves working as one. Please, one card in clarity, a whisper of love for this Aries collective, sun, moon, rising, Venus sign, twin flame contract, August, September 2020, involving this goddess archetype, divine feminine, and this beggar archetype, divine masculine. Please, please, what is the clarifying message about this twin flame contract from the higher self of all involved for this Aries twin flame? Please just leave it in my hand. Just the one, please. Have faith. Trust. Trust your faith in this situation. Oh, the card's backwards. I'm going to think that's more for the divine masculine, but trust your faith in this situation, because particularly if divine feminine, you get that there is a trick being played here, but it's like sometimes the gods are just playing chess with our lives. We don't know that we're part of it, right? Someone might not even know that they're being deceptive because what they've shown seems to be so real. So have faith. Trust in your faith in this situation. This card has not come up in a very, very, very long time, and I'm glad it has for you, particularly for the beggar here, who is really looking at this life-changing decision. And that's funny, again, what you seem to both have is very much, I don't want to say selfish in a negative way, but like self-sufficient, that's a good way, or the self-esteem is in place, or I don't know how exactly to say that, but you're probably more alike than not, and that might be confusing things rather than making them easier in terms of boundaries, right? So to drink from the emerald fountain of your own hearts individually, from Kuan Yin and the eternal star of guidance, right, to really follow that, and don't do anything that feels off, because have faith. Trust your faith in this situation, which is saying that not necessarily trust the other person. Maybe you do, maybe you don't. But to trust that this is a twin flame and you are being transformed, only being transformed for the better, though you may not be together for more than a reason or a season, but who knows about the lifetime, family members, it can go that way. Breathe. Our last card down, a healing mantra from the Ascended Masters themselves, please. My Ascended Masters of Twin Flame Contracts, please, one card in clarity. What is the perfect healing mantra for this Aries Collective Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign, Twin Flame Contract, evolving the Goddess Archetype and the Beggar Archetype, August, September, or timeless? These are timeless readings. I know that. These are timeless. Whenever they're supposed to watch this, what is their perfect healing mantra, please? Opening my mind. I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas. Opening my mind. I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas. Now, keep in mind, Aries, you're ruled by the head. So even though you might think of yourself as a more fire energy and this is a very air thing, do keep in mind, this is all you. Let me read you this, and then we'll pop up the larger picture. Hold on one second. We just shot right past it. Overcoming fear, opening my mind. I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas. When your mind opens, you are no longer limited by fearful beliefs or at odds with your own healing journey. Remember, this is for either one of you. With an open mind, you are aware of a bigger cosmic picture where your personal life ushers in your highest potential by uplifting the consciousness of humanity. In other words, your own personal journey is serving in a much higher level, which is true of twin flame contracts. I mean, as one of us heals, all of us heals. Of course, there's a larger, higher dimensional purpose for all twin flame contracts, not just torturing you and getting you ready for your soulmate, although that's part of the journey. As your mind opens, life is not just centered around your personal gains and losses, but shining your light for the well-being of all wherever you happen to be. This mantra is ideal for ending the inner negotiation with the ego, very much a first house thing, personality, ego, stuff, unraveling self-sabotage, first house, and confronting the inevitability of loss, because there is no gain without loss, and there is no loss without gain. Loss and gain! Wow. Let's pop up the bigger picture, see what else I get, and then, if you like, follow me over into the extended, where we will be doing simple timeline for each of them and clarifying with a whole other different deck. First things first. Breathe. Because we've got the divine feminine here, the goddess archetype, the shadow attribute, exploitation of the female nature and form, the light attribute, the feminine expressed through wisdom, nature, life force, and sensuality, walking with the angel of meditation. So kind of really getting overall from her, what she wants, right? That Ten of Cups, that emotional fulfillment, that bliss, that ecstasy. And she can get it by really evaluating her loyalty systems, her honor code right now. What is she willing to wait for? What is she not willing to wait for? Because she is dealing with somebody, just again, looking over here at the Divine Masculine, with perhaps some trust issues, the Angel of Trust at work there, and with a decision on their mind. And what's on her mind, again, I'm doing his and her in terms of Divine Feminine, Divine Masculine, what's on her mind is Shakti the Life Dancer, that this is the end of something so that something new can come up. At least that's how she's seeing it, that's what she's believing it, that's what she's thinking about, is perhaps putting this puppy to rest, or at least ending a chapter within it, not through the death card, but through the card of the world, literally closing a chapter and then jumping again into something new. But we'll see how that goes, or I guess you will. The extended should give more clarity there. And what's going on in her heart? The Three of Cups. She feels the emotional bond, but it's a three. It's not that Two of Attraction. There might very well be that feeling of connection, of kinship, which could be part of the trick. Just because you're feeling someone empathic doesn't mean it's a soulmate. Can mean it is indeed a twin flame, and you are learning how to negotiate your loyalties and your boundary systems around your own emotional bonds and empathic skill. Just saying, with that Coyote Woman, the Trickster, which is a major arcana card. Sure, it's half of the Devil card, but it is that part of really being tricked into something so that you learn, grow, heal, and evolve. Otherwise, you would have never set foot in that desert of wandering and wondering. Jumping over here to the Divine Masculine, we've got the Beggar archetype, the shadow attribute, dependence on others to the exclusion of effort, right? It's, look, we all have to ask for help. This is not that. This is about, in the shadow, an inability, a dependence on others to the exclusion of effort. So we're not talking somebody who's physically disabled or disabled in any way and needs help. We're talking about someone who has a dependence on others without their effort, right? Now, I don't feel like that would, I could imagine somebody being born into that with a serious disability, but there's a certain amount of healing that only we can do for ourselves. And, you know, just part of my journey as a healer, I know that there's always healing available, though it may not look the way we expect it to look. But if there is a dependence on others to the exclusion of effort, then that's where really the shadow beggar is a problem, because the light is so bright, confronts empowerment at the level of physical survival. So no matter what it takes, I am going to learn to empower myself here, awakening the spiritual authority of humility, compassion, and self-esteem, and ultimately a surrender to the divine, which I see in that hanged man, but we'll get there. I mean, what they want is fast movement and fast communication and fast passion. This Eight of Wands, well, come on, let's get on with it, get on with it. And actually, they have the means to do that. That card of the Chariot there, I mean, emotionally, they're kind of willing to charge ahead, regardless of the positives and the negatives, except they might not have yet, because they are doing that card of the Lovers, right? That decision in play, that back and forth between the head and the heart. How does the throat chakra choose on this one? So maybe chewing on this one for a little bit, because emotionally, got the Hangman there, Prometheus bound, right? Just a sacrifice having to be made, hanging out, not really knowing, at an impasse, but also perhaps opening to more inspiration and healing, because does have, again, this angel of trust walking them through this. There is a Six of Swords process going on here on the level of spirit. The soul says that there is a moving from more turbulent, perhaps unsafe environment to one that is a bit more calmer, clearer, cleaner, so that there can be a deeper internal stuff going on here, even though it's a divine masculine, because both of them are being told drink from the Emerald Fountain. Now, I'm going to feel the goddess archetype here, the divine feminine with that Three of Cups is going to have access to that. The divine masculine here with this card of trust, can they find the trust there within themselves to drink from the Emerald Fountain, the divine love, to turn that in a spiritual direction? Particularly with the Archangel Michael saying the eternal star, that card of guidance, to do what feels right, but it's more than just an emotional thing. It really is, what is your heart saying? Not just your emotional mood. What is your heart, your core, communicating to you in terms of what feels right and what doesn't? Because there is more to come, right? The card of have faith from the higher selves. Trust your faith in this situation. This isn't just to torture you. This isn't just to keep you apart or to slam you together in ways that feel really tricky and turbulent, but transformative. That there is a higher thing here, and allow yourself to see beyond your beliefs and ideas. That mantra of opening the mind. I allow myself, right? Not even to say that I'm going to do it perfectly. I allow myself to see beyond my beliefs and ideas, cracks that open a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more with each repetition. So that drinking from the Emerald Fountain, giving yourselves the love that you both need individually from the divine feminine within you, regardless of which side of the table you're on here, will really help you with that eternal star shining within you, really giving you guidance, giving you grace, giving you direction, that as long as you have faith and trust in the situation and open your mind, you will get what you need out of this twin flame contract, August, September 2020, at least within your own healing. Well, that's a whole lot, and it's a really good foundation for now what I'm going to do in the extended, which I'm going to pull. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull three Mythic Tarot, past, present, future, for the goddess, and three Daughters of the Moon tarot. Yep, I'm switching them around for the divine masculine there to sort of get more their divine masculine and their divine feminine, if you get what I'm saying, which should really clarify if you've really resonated with this reading. And then we'll see what else I'm going to pull. I've got a whole other deck back there, the Chuck Spazzano Love Pack, I'm thinking of pulling for this or that or this or that, but we'll see. cool. So please follow on the Vimeo link below in the description box. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. May the Aries Collective Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs be blessed with all that they need in their twin flame contracts, August and September 2020, that they may heal, that they may grow, that they may be the best that they can be, opening their mind, having faith, following their guidance, and drinking from the divine love within them for their well-being and for the well-being of all. So mo to be, and so it is. Thank you for watching again. Please like, subscribe, comment, all that jazz. You know the deal. Otherwise, wishing you the very best and the very blessed in this twin flame contract, August, September 2020. Hail, farewell, blessed be, and maybe I'll see you over in part two. Bye bye. Hey there, my Aries. Thank you so much for coming over to the extended reading. It's been a long time since I've done one of these. This time the gods, the masters, all of them were like very, very clear to do this. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be getting two simple timelines, past, present, future, one for the divine feminine, one for the divine masculine, and then we are going to be using the Chuck Spazzano Love Pack to clarify anything else that is screaming out for clarification, right? So let's have fun with this if we can, because we've got a goddess archetype and a beggar archetype. Remember, I don't know which one is the Aries. I don't know which one. I mean, you can comment below if you like. This is video on demand, so any people, I think only people who will actually purchase the reading will be able to comment. But hey, knock yourself out. Otherwise, let's do this. Now, since we worked with the Daughters of the Moon for the Divine Feminine, we're going to switch decks. keeping in mind that all of those other tarot cards are still there for the Divine Masculine. But we're going to ask the Divine Masculines, the gods, to comment here for a past, present, future, right? Let's do this. Breathe. This is fun. I can feel this. My gods, please. Three cards, simple timeline for this goddess archetype in this Aries collective, sun, moon, rising, Venus sign. Twin flame contract for August and September 2020 or timeless, whenever they are watching this, please. One card for the past. We'll do them face down. One card, that's where they've been in this contract. Where are they right now? In this contract, which should be displayed pretty much in that element spread, and where are they headed in this twin flame contract, at least in context of August, September 2020. And let me do the same, Daughters of the Moon, for the Divine Masculine, my goddesses, yay! We're blending the yin and the yang. How exciting. Perfect for a twin flame raid, please. Three cards, simple timeline, past, present, future, for this beggar archetype in this Aries collective, sun, moon, rising, Venus sign, twin flame contract, August and September 2020. Please, one card in clarity. Where has the beggar been in this contract? Where is the beggar now in this contract? Would certainly be indicated for them what's going on and what's already on the table for them. And lastly, at least for this deck, where are they headed? Where is this beggar archetype headed? We'll take that one in this Aries collective. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign, twin flame contract. August, September 2020. So where have they been? The goddess and the lovers. The Six of Cups in opposition. Okay, so really the past here says where both of them have been. She's very much missing him. Again, I'm saying divine feminine her, divine masculine him. Switch the genders up, please. But he, oppressed, oppression. The card of the devil. Now the other half of this, right? So these cards put together would be the devil card in this system, but it's a feminist deck, so it doesn't use patriarchal imagery in that way, but we'll say that this person is oppressed probably with the judgments, thoughts, and fears of others, or particularly the well-meaning fears of others. Could be societal, tribal chains, just their own psychology that they have been struggling with.